After 5 minutes, you switch it off.
Very heartiest good morning, my friends and respected teachers. Group Revolution welcome you to the magic world of Linux. My group members are Amey Das, Abhijit Gupta, Sudhit Padan, and myself, Sukesh Kumar Randin. Firstly, our group has been named so because I believe after the end of this presentation, many of you will be trying out Linux. In this presentation, we are going to tell you how Linux works and we'll be busting some myths. This is the theme used by Red Hat, the most established corporation of Linux. Truth happens, if you are a Linux user, first they ignore you, then they laugh at you, then they fight you, then you win. Now we come to history and motivation. GNU project started in 1984 to produce Unix-like operating system. In 1985, Richard Stallman wrote GNU Manifesto. That is software or open source. Now what is open source? It's software or application which program code is available to all and can be further developed. In early 90s, GNU utilities was complete, and in 1991, Linus Torvalds completed the first version of Linux, which first called distros and later named Linux after his name. Now why choose Linux? Linux is a complete operating system that is stable. That is, if you are using Linux, the bring down of operating system is much less under Linux. It's reliable. That is, if you use Windows, there will be need of regular rebooting, but Linux server are often up to 100 disks compared with Linux. Compared with Windows, it is extremely powerful. It's true multitasking that can run more than one program at a time. It's a version of Unix and it is based on same programming code as Unix called BSD. It's free, it is easy to download, and it's open source. Beyond all this, it's a true multitasking and support multiple processors at a time. It has lot of versions to choose from. Examples are Ubuntu, Fedora, Ubuntu, SUSE, OpenSUSE, Linux Mint, etc. And some new versions are Fedora 15, Linux Mint 10, Linux Mint 12, and there are more about 10,000 versions of Linux. Now to continue. Abhijit and Anil will come. Thank you.
Hello and good morning everyone. I am Abhijit Gupta.
Good morning everyone. My name is Anil Das.
Let us continue our journey with Linux versus Windows. The basic difference between Windows and Linux lies in these three points. Technical difference, financial differences.
Technical differences.
And end user differences. Financial differences. Let's come to cost. For online downloads, you get to download Linux for free because it is easily available on the net. Whereas for Windows, you don't get to download it from the net except for the few pirated ones. Let's come to retail prices. The prices which you pay for are mainly for the Linux server in essence. And for Windows, it is about 6 times or more.
Technical differences. Keeping up to date by upgrading Linux. Its upgrades are faster than Windows and obviously it is free. Compatibility. Linux is backward compatible unlike Windows. Let us take an example. If you by any chance install Windows 98 on your computer, you will have to enforce CID just to find the drivers which is not available on the web. Whereas drivers for even the first version of Linux is also available on the web. Features provided. Both support dynamic caching, both have multi-user support. That is, one OS can be shared by many users.
End user differences. Windows versus open source. Windows uses proprietary technology. Now the question arises, what exactly is proprietary technology? Let me explain. Proprietary technology is the softwares or applications which have paid licenses. For example, Windows copyright and it shows, that is the program code is enclosed. That is, you cannot access them, only the members who have done it can access them. Complete information needed for download. Suppose you want to download a Linux software on your Linux operating system, then you always get an option to download its source code or the program code, which can be further developed. Technical help. Talking about technical help, Ubuntu online blog, that is a blog where you can post your questions. In this blog, you can post questions about any problem in Linux, whether it be it Ubuntu, Fedora, anything, and it will be answered just within a day by experts.
Security and other means. I hope all of you listen FM radio. In the advertisement of Quick Heal, they say, aapke computer mein kya hai? Virus or Quick Heal?
My answer is, I am safe from both of them. Let me elaborate on this. What happens is that if you are trying to download a software, a virus gets downloaded. So, and generally what happens, viruses are generally of exe format, that is self-executable. They reproduce themselves and hack your system, or rather slow down your system. In Windows, they can do this with ease. But in Linux, each time a file is to be executed, it seeks for your permissions, that is a password. And so you can make a collection of viruses without executing them. And they will not affect your system unless you want. And talking about viruses, I guess I don't have to tell how antiviruses slows down your operating system. Linux is very tough to use. It is not user friendly.
No, it isn't. It is far more user friendly than you can think. You can see in this picture, this is just one example. Its visual interface is as easy and as Windows, if not easier. You can do almost anything with Linux. It has multiple desktops. It is for everyone, whether you are a geek or a movie freak or a gamer, anything. I guess most of you have used Linux, used Android mobile phones, which is completely Linux based and it is easy to use. So Linux is user friendly as Android is Linux. Linux is not used so much, so Linux is safer.
See, here in this table, this shows the usage of OS in operating system, in servers. See, Linux is 63.90%. So we can't say that Linux is useless. So it's baseless to say such a thing. In this graph shows a survey done by Top 500 magazine. This graph shows the usage of OS in supercomputers. See, this is Unix, the blue one, and the yellow one is Linux, and I'll talk about Windows a little later. See, Unix was ruling this market, okay? And now see Linux, where Linux was in 1998 and where it is now in 2011, it is completely ruling this market. And Windows, I guess you can see this blue line, this suggests Windows. Linux isn't secure, Windows is much more secure.
I say no, it is far more secure. The reason being is permission in Linux. As far as I know, you can keep your files safe in My Documents, C drive, which no one can access except the user in Windows. But in Linux, you can keep your file anywhere, you just have to change permission. You can see in this picture, you can allot different permission to different user. It be read and write, read write and read only execution. Linux is free, so it has lots of bugs.
Given enough eyeballs, all bugs are shallow, because we are all part of this open source family. Let me enlighten on this. Suppose a user spots a bug, okay? Then what happens is, and it doesn't always have to be the Linux team to spot the bug, that user or the Linux teams spots the bugs, rectifies them and uploads them, and with each update your bugs are fixed. But all of this happens with the speed of light. But in Windows, whenever a bug is to be fixed, it takes months and months of time, because only a handful do it, that is the Windows team. And to continue with the presentation, my friend Sudipto will continue. Thank you
Abhijit. Thank you, Anand. Good morning everybody, myself Sudipto Da, and I am going to discuss tools and application of Linux. At first, we see in slide, no searching for softwares. Find everything in software manager and above all of them are free. Generally, what happens is, someone recommends you a software, you go and buy it, or download a pirated version of it. But here, in Linux, it is like a one-stop shopper's point. That is software vendor. Next, we come LibreOffice. It is absolutely free and can read any format of documents. We all know that Microsoft Office is closed source. That is, we don't know its source code till LibreOffice can read it. But the opposite thing is not true. Next we come VIM editor. VIM editor, the world most powerful editor. It can open up to 5 FI up to 2 GB in 2010. And the news is that it is to increase its capacity up to 10 times more. And it is act as a compiler to many high-level languages like C, C++, etc. Why? With the help of this software, you can run almost any Windows software. After why, we come VirtualBox. The VirtualBox is very useful. If you run Windows or other OSs while working on Linux, then that is your go-to software. And guess what? It is absolutely free. Compete, the ultimate eye candy. Accent is louder than what? Let's see it in action. What you see now in the slide is called 3D desktop effect. And this is wobbly effect. All of this you see now is because of Compete. Next, we move on facts and advantages of Linux. Linux is used by both Wikipedia and Google and many other big companies, but it is their custom-made Linux OS. It has best managed I/O. Have you ever thought of writing it in Hopex? It does that too. I have tried it, and believe it, it takes 7 minutes to write a 5 GB file. Amazing, isn't it? Linux is a OS which is used most for hacking. It is the fastest among all OSs. For example, Google's Chrome OS, a version of Linux, it takes 4 seconds to boot desktop. If everything is free, then there has to be no chance of piracy. Next slide, please. Conclusion. Thus, we conclude that if you are a Linux user, they first they ignore you,
then they laugh at you,
then they fight you,
then you win. I guess Group Revolution has convinced at least some of you to try out Linux, and there's a surprise. The best question of this morning will get a DVD of Linux to try Linux out. Thank you.
Now I'd like to call all of my fellow group members, please come on the stage.
Questions, please. Yes, Yogi.
Can you tell me something about, like you talked about open source, so what is actually open source software licensing?
Open source software is a copyright computer software with source code is available to all, and you can use it without paying to original author. It was made by Richard Stallman only to make fun on copyright. It named it copyleft.
See, where this in this open source, the copyleft means that all the developers of the previous versions will be there and your name will be included in the last. That is the latest developer.
That means like Linux is free, so it's an open source.
Yes, you can develop a Linux version of your own.
My question for you
is,
why Windows gets hacked more often than Linux?
Thank you, Soji. This is the question I was waiting for. What happens is, I guess all of you have connected your internet using a mobile? Yes or no? Yes? See, whenever you start a dial-up, there is a message showing that opening ports. I guess all of you have noticed. What Windows does that, it opens all the ports. That is the wireless, that is the Wi-Fi ports, the Bluetooth ports, the USB ports, and all kinds of ports. And Windows lets the ports open for any time, any number of time, and any one port is connected and the rest are open. What happens? The hacker maps all these ports. You get it? The hacker maps all these ports and intrudes in one of them. And in Linux, what happens that each time a port is opened, it checks for its connection, and the port is closed immediately if there is no connection. And if there is connection, only that port is open and all rest are closed. Yes.
Can we use Linux in phones?
You use Android?
Yes.
My friend Dana told you that Linux is Android is completely Linux based. Completely Linux based. Yeah.
How do you run Windows software applications in Linux?
In our presentation, my friend Sudipto had shown you why.
You can remember? Use Y or virtual box.
Yes, you can install Windows software or install Windows itself.
All the softwares.
Almost like Visual Basic, it won't run because it's completely Windows developing software. It won't run. But others will run. Yes.
Are there any disadvantages of Linux compared to Windows?
There are. Like, if you know, some of you might be using ATI graphics card. Yes. And NVIDIA graphics card. See, there is a confliction between ATI and Linux open source. ATI produces proprietary software. I told you what is proprietary software. So the support of this proprietary software is not as good as for NVIDIA drivers. So the gaming platform is bit less compared to Windows.